Strategy number four was to focus on the team. So what one of the things that I learned was I couldn't do it myself. I couldn't do it all on my own because I wasn't involved in every single decision and activity that was involved and required to make the changes. Because I often use the phrase that spare parts management is a team sport. You end up with maintenance, planning, procurement, storeroom, even finance. All of these different groups have their part of the puzzle that they bring to the picture. And so what you need to do is you need to engage with the team, train the team to make sure that they understand not only what it is you want them to do to improve, but why you need them to do it. And my experience is once people can see the why, then the what will follow. And I know that when I often encounter maintenance people who I'm told are completely intractable about spare parts, I can talk to them because I'm a maintenance guy. I understand their concerns and issues. But by explaining the logic, if I go back a couple of steps, by explaining the logic about what it is that we're trying to achieve and pointing out the illogic of some of the things that have happened, they tend to get won over and start thinking, oh, there is a better way. There is some more certainty for them. So you need to think about the team. I've been involved with a procurement team, and I'm not just hitting on procurement today, but there's another procurement example that one of their metrics was lowest unit cost for purchasing. And so they may get a signal to buy 5 of an item that's the reorder quantity for that item, but they can cut a good deal if they buy 15. And so they want lowest unit cost. They buy 15, they go on the shelf, and guess what? 14 of them don't get used. And so they've spent a whole bunch of money, they've put stuff on the shelf, hasn't done the organization any good at all. So by getting the team involved, you all get on the same page, as they say, to be able to achieve a result.